Great. Hi, my name is Kim Hordell-Holoka, and I'm one of the phys ed and health consultants on the comprehensive school health team with Edmonton Public Schools. And I'm actually going to talk to you a little bit about today and go through with you the ABCDs of movement, which is one of the, I would say, probably the one of the best resources to use, especially for elementary generalist teachers. There's one for every grade level, starting in kindergarten all the way to grade 6, and really connects beautifully to our Alberta curriculum in physical education. So this resource, the ABCDs of movement, it's part of the physical education curriculum, and it's a supporting resource, I think, more than anything for the elementary grades. So when we look at it, what's fantastic about it is that we've got a kindergarten resource all the way up to grade 6. So it makes it so much easier for the generalist teacher or the elementary school teacher to focus in on the correct areas, I guess, for the curriculum that really help meet the Alberta curriculum. And I think more than anything, what I love about this one is, especially when I first started teaching, is it there's so much in the curriculum and there's so many different ways of looking at the curriculum, whether it's phys ed to health, to language arts, to math. There's so much that a teacher needs to try to fit in. But having a resource like this is kind of like a one-stop shop to kind of find everything or fit everything into the year with your students. So the one I'm kind of demoing or looking at today is the grade 5 one. So when you first open it, when we look at the first page, it talks a little bit about, it gives you some ideas on some year plan templates, unit plans, lesson plans, and then it focuses in on different areas or different units. For example, games, individual activities, as well as some areas of dance and gymnastics. So looking at the table of contents, again, it kind of breaks it down, and when we look at the lessons, and this is kind of in a year plan order and how they have it here. Now again, that doesn't mean you have to follow this to a T, but it definitely just gives you a really good outline of what to look at. Throughout then in the appendix, which is nice, is what I love about this part is, again, is cross-curricularizing your phys ed curriculum along with language arts, math, health, etc. So there's actually children's literature links, which is really, really nice to connect to and really easy fit to then connect and cross-curricularize your phys ed within your classroom as well. And then again, as I said before, is your year plans, your unit plans, and the lesson plan template. Warm-up and cool-down stretches, again, which is so, so important, and I think we need to always reconnect to that, is when we look at doing our lessons is having a strong warm-up as well as a cool-down in there as well. And there's some student activities in here as well. And then, of course, your scope and sequence. What it starts with, again, is a quick general overview or general outcomes of the ABCDs. So A being activity, which is your locomotor, non-locomotor, manipulatives. Your general outcome B, which is benefiting health. General outcome C, cooperation. And then D is doing it daily, doing it for life. And that's where we really connect as well to daily physical activity and our DPA of 30 minutes a day. The other nice piece to this is we talk about, when we look at our district priorities, we talk about citizenship, creativity, innovation, and that right there in a nutshell hits all four of these areas so perfectly well. The other nice thing is in here, this is the grade 5 one, but for every grade level, what I love about being a phys ed specialist is we make it easy. We simplify as best we can. And looking at our outcomes, our specific outcomes in each one of our ABCDs. So when we're looking at this, it's so easily connecting. So we look at basic skills. So for example, select, perform, refine, more challenging locomotor sequences. So that would be A51, so that's that specific outcome. And then when we look, and I'm just going to kind of turn, I'll come back to here, but I just want to connect to how it looks in an actual lesson. Is when I look here, for example, this is lesson 5 of games, but I was talking about that A51, which is that basic skill of locomotor movement. Well, right here, in this lesson, we are hitting all of these specific outcomes, and they're already laid out and done for you. So it really takes the pressure off the teacher of doing that work, because it's already laid out and completed. So kind of that's what, which is really nice here. So connecting it, kind of a two-pager quick overview of what the program of studies looks like, and those specific outcomes that by the end of grade 5, my students should be able to do. again, back to kind of looking at a glance as different activities that we can look at. And what we've done is we've actually broken it down into five major categories in K to 6 phys ed. So look, and target games. So again, nice idea of breaking it down so we're not so specifically into a sport. And when we look at our curriculum now and with the changes that are coming with having a new curriculum coming out in 2016, is really looking at fundamental movement skills or physical literacy. So being able to break it down and not as much as a specific sport, but looking at it in a different way, meaning innovative, goal-oriented, net and wall and target. Here on the next two pages is the examples of year plans. Again, this is just an example. Again, when I started teaching, I used this and I followed it to a T. And also being a phys ed specialist, I started to add other things in from other resources. But this again just was an easy fit to making sure I was hitting the curriculum. So in September, they look at games. What I like about it is it connects to goal-oriented games. They talk more about soccer, but it doesn't mean if we go back to this page, the page before, there's different ones. We don't have to just go with soccer. There's other ideas there. The general outcomes, so it's going to hit the A, the B, the C, and the D. And then specifically, what areas of the are in that unit that we're going to hit specific outcomes. So really nicely set up. It talks about here, with assessment and evaluation, it says refer to the Physical Education Guide for Implementation, K to 12. Again, there's so many fantastic assessment ideas and resources there. And again, what we're looking at is continuing to add to this resource and looking at assessments that actually connect to each one of these units. And there's some ideas as I show you throughout. Again, resources or facilities. So it talks about gymnasium fields, and most of them are done in the gymnasium, but many of these can also be modified and extended to be done in the field outside, in hallways, and in our classrooms. So it really, again, connects to if we're working in a school, for example, K to 9, only has one gym, 800 students, you know, how do we fit in our phys ed curriculum? Is a lot of these can be modified and changed to fit into your classroom as well. And then it continues to go on, so on the next page, all the way from February to June again. So usually in June, you'll find track and field. And again, what I love, I will constantly go back to this, is that connection to the specific outcomes, because it's done for you, which is wonderful. The next few pages are kind of more about how do we plan it? Do we have a 30-minute phys ed class? Do we have, you know, is it 60-minute phys ed classes? So it helps you with that, gives you some ideas on how we can actually set up planning. So the planning piece talks about here, talking about kind of connecting to reading the resource. So those bolded terms, are going to be more your important terms. And then it talks about capital letters, illustrated examples that are explained at the end of each lesson. Some lessons contain additional activities to be able to extend, and some of them actually contain some cross-curricular activities as well. Turning over the page, it just talks about some things to connect to reminding about classroom management, which is so crucial. Beginning of every year in phys ed, one of the most important, probably the key thing, is really setting up a structured environment, because it is such an unstructured environment that we need to make sure there's structure in place for our students, establishing those routines and those rules so our children are successful, each and every single one of our students, especially with inclusive education in our inclusive classrooms. Other things to consider, so looking at classroom climate, different ways of putting kids into groupings, because that's always an issue, and things to consider, so it really talks about that. Talks about fair playing rules, activities, you know, maximizing activity time, so the less sitting, the more doing, and it talks a little bit about that, so using brief, concise wording, cue ideas, you know, are you going to use a whistle? What ways are you going to connect to our students to get them, you know, to listen to your instructions and then continue to move? Using music was always one of the key pieces that I connected to. When the music stopped, my students knew that it was time to stop, put their eyes and ears on me so they could hear the next activity or the next instruction and then be able to move forward quickly. Again, we talk about practicing organizational skills. So different, again, these are different ideas, and be able, and some will work for your students and some won't. So trying them is probably the best thing to do, is just to try them and see where it goes. And of course, most importantly, is providing that safe environment. And I like how it connects here because this is really, really important and is really connecting it to the safety guidelines for physical activity in Alberta schools. The 2008 one is online and every school should have one, but making sure that you connect to that with safety in all the different units that you're doing in phys ed. Again, warm up, really important, connecting to that. And I like this because it's very easily set out. As you can see, I love these because this is how I draw. So I feel like it's a good connection to me. I'm not much of an artist. So having Stickman in here, again, just gives you an idea of what you're looking at. Because sometimes it's hard for teachers and educators to look at this and truly understand what am I supposed to be doing with my students or what should it look like. So having these little Stickman illustrations is really good to have. Again, these are just the quick sample warm-up idea head to toe stretches. But again, it's done for you, so you don't have to spend the time online or coming up with it already because it's done. Again, I think this is an area that's really important. I've already kind of connected to it and talked a little bit about it, but having that inclusive classroom. A lot of our students in our schools now, when we look at inclusive education, one of the areas where we really start to add and connect that inclusive education is in the physical education world, so in the gym. So again, really connecting and looking at these tips for an active inclusive in special needs in our physical education. These again, different ideas looking at receiving objects, projecting an object, and retaining an object. So this is really, when I talk about fundamental movement skills and physical literacy, this is the connection piece there with our students. So how should our students be able to receive an object? What are some ideas or what are some strategies as a teacher that I can do to help my students so they are successful? So again, looking at this, it talks about Velcro, you know, throwing and receiving objects using the Velcro balls. Again, really easy, simple way for every student to feel successful. Retaining objects, again, connecting it to that inclusive education model. Again, just as we continue here, it continues to talk about some modifications and strategies to use so all students are successful when doing activities, whether it's in here we talk about dance. Looking at individual activities, so as you can see, there's been a lot of pages added and connected to inclusive education, and I think that, again, is looking at making sure each and every one of our students are feeling successful and creative in the units that we do in physical education. But also in here, it talks about types of formations. Again, these are really, really good because, you know, we usually connect to back what we knew and how we were taught. But having these ideas in front of us is able, you know, gives us new ideas of going, hey, you know what, I always do the single circle, maybe I should try the double circle, you know, or instead of line formations, maybe it's a scattered pattern or a fan pattern. So it gives you those ideas. And again, every grade level has these. They may be modified a little bit. My kindergarten grade levels isn't gonna be specifically this, but it does give you this idea. So this is kind of setting you up and getting you ready to then move into the units. So I'll kind of quickly go through how this works. So this one, if we look back at the year, and they gave you that sample year plan at the beginning, is the first unit that they talk about is games for grade 5. And again, on the side it says here, it's the goal-oriented soccer-type game. So you know that most of these lessons are going to be around soccer-type activities. So again, when we open it up, this would be lesson 1. What I love is that it talks about, again, is that connection piece to the curriculum. Specifically, what outcomes are we hitting in the curriculum? So here's our general outcomes, here's our specific outcomes. Then again, as we talked about before, it's really important to have that warm-up and that cool-down. So it talks about the warm-up right here. Then it goes into the learning activities. So when I show you this lesson and when I flip the page, you're going to see everything set up exactly the same. So you're going to have an introduction warm-up. Then the learning activities, so the teaching strategies, the activities. So here we're actually looking at the skill around dribbling. And again, it talks about key criteria. So in here it talks about how do we help our students be successful? So what are some things that they need to be able to do to be successful at dribbling? So keeping the ball close to our feet, using the inside and the outside of the foot, pushing the ball rather than kicking it. Dribble, keeping eyes and head up and using either foot. Now again, granted, this is grade five. So is this gonna be the same in grade one, grade two? No. Are my key criteria is gonna be the same around dribbling? No, it's gonna be very, very different. But the setup of this is exactly the same. So again, they have six different things to do around dribbling. And then, seven, and then here. Now what I like here as well is it has a variation piece. So the variation piece is having changing speeds of dribbling, allowing the trees to stick out the trees. And again, it talks, if you go back into the activity here, one group of students are the trees, and then the other group is the ones that are moving around the trees. And then it talks about the closure cool down. And then it talks about a glossary of terms. So dribble, what exactly is a dribble? And what exactly is personal space? So those are two key elements for us as educators to know that I need to know ahead of time before I can really go out and teach this lesson. Also in here connects to the safety considerations and then the equipment that I need for this lesson. Now what I like here, and we didn't have this in the first lesson, but it's the more curriculum connections. So it talks about health and it talks about group roles and processes. So in health, we're actually meeting R5.8, which we have a notes page after each unit. So if you need to write down some ideas or notes after that lesson one, you know, what worked really well, maybe there was something you want to go back and reconnect to, just a quick little jot note. And then this, again, I told you at the beginning that there was a literature link. So these, all of these connect, and it talks about grade levels and it's some good literature links. And again, this is in every K-6 book as well. Here is a sample year plan that you can use, and again, really easily laid out, as well as unit plan template, as well as a lesson plan template. And again, it has this already in place for you, so it's literally just writing them in, and it's already done and finished for you. Warm up and cool down ideas. So again, we had some at the beginning, but here's just a little bit more, I think more of a broader, but then also extending it even more. So looking at full body warm-up stretches and cool downs. And again, loving our little stick men that help us with us visual learners. and then again, I talked about the student activity record sheet. So what again is really good with the assessment piece and connecting it with the assessment. And being able to add some individual assessments as well. Again, different ideas and different ways to lead up. Looking in here, which is really nice for dance, is what areas of the body am I using around elements of dance? Space, force, time, relationship of body parts and formations. Again, already done for you. And I think that's the biggest piece is looking at this. It talks about, gives you so many incredible ideas of being able to cross-curricularize at the same time as meeting the phys ed curriculum needs. And as well as meeting other areas of the curriculum needs around health, et cetera, et cetera. In here, it also has some ideas for track and field. So some track and field days, ways that you can set it up for track, again, in every single grade level. And then last but not least, it talks about the scope and sequence of the ABCDs and movement. So it talks about here in kindergarten, these are the units are in kindergarten. These are all the grade 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And showing that they really do connect. So what we learned in grade 5, I'm gonna continue to use in grade 6 and continue to use when I move into junior high and high school. These books are incredible to use because they, one, hit the curriculum. They're very specific on what you're doing. They help you really set up what your phys ed year can look like. The work is already completed for you. And to be honest with you, they're extremely successful. I've had such great success in every grade level that I've taught K-6 with this book. So I would highly recommend it.